As reports of healings, apparitions, visions of a dangerous future and bilocation, being in two places at the same time, as these reports swirled around Maria Esperanza in Venezuela, another man far off was suffering in a brutal prison. His alleged crime was being a Catholic, his sentence death by freezing. It seemed only divine intervention could save him. Exiled from his native Ukraine, living now in Toronto, Canada, he claims to hold the secret to hundreds of divinely inspired prophecies. Visionary and mystic Joseph Terelya.
I'm
an instrument in God's hands.
And there are
a lot of things that I don't understand.
Today, living in freedom, Joseph Terelya appears to be an ordinary family man content to while away the hours painting. But a closer look at his art and his life will reveal the anguish and triumph of a modern-day prophet. Author Michael Brown.
Joseph Terelya is a truly remarkable mystic, as well as a martyr. I mean, he never died, but he certainly suffered long and hard, 20 years in the Soviet prison system for being a Catholic activist in the dark, cold days of communism.
Joseph Terelya's odyssey of seemingly miraculous survival, prison escapes, and reported encounters with spiritual beings began the day he was thrown into prison at the age of 19. Dr. Roman Krutsky.
The reason he was placed in prisons was because of the violation of the Soviet code prohibiting the practice of religion. In fact, all forms of religious activity were totally abolished. The churches were desecrated in many ways. In some cases, they used them as outhouses. They would convert some of them into museums.
Hundreds and thousands were the priests and nuns who were actually executed for their religious activities. So it was a tremendously trying time.
Trapped inside the monolithic Soviet prison system, Joseph had two roads to freedom: renounce his religion or escape.
Joseph successfully escaped from Soviet prisons 9 times.
He was relentless in finding his freedom. I think one of the greatest miracles of his life is the fact that this man was never executed. They never did kill him. They tried a couple times, and they certainly tortured him. He was put into cells that were, there wasn't even enough room to move his knees when he sat down, cages that were cold, given only bread to eat.
They found it very hard to physically control him. They repeatedly tried to break his spirit by physically damaging him. So his hands were broken 5 times. They tried to dispose of him by putting him into a room with several murderers who were armed with knives. They slit the veins in the back of the legs and just left him there. Fortunately, a guard saw this happening and he managed to get him out before he was dead.
Eventually, Joseph Terelya's time ran out. Prison officials had had enough.
They decided to kill Joseph by putting him in what they called a freeze cell. It was a cell where they piped in the cold, frigid Russian air. This is 100 miles northeast of Moscow.
They put me in the cell. They took away my coverings. It's hard to describe how cold it was. My eyebrows became heavy. The ends of my hair began to hurt.
At one point, he got up so he could get his head near this light bulb that was hanging from the ceiling for the warmth, because everything was so cold.
I pushed my head up against the light to try to heat my head. The guard there saw what I was doing and he switched off the light.
Death was imminent. It seemed Joseph was about to meet his maker.
The physiology of his body was following its normal course. So he lay down on the cot, body now very, very numb, and his eyelids were literally at this point frozen together. He couldn't open his eyes. As he was going through this, he was praying his final prayers, asking for the Blessed Virgin to help him in this hour of travail.
Joseph claims his prayers were answered and his life forever changed.
At this very moment, I felt an intensive light shining in through the cell, and I couldn't raise my eyebrows, but I felt a light surround me and warm me.
He opened his eyes, and there before him was a beautiful, luminous woman whom he took to be the Virgin Mary. She said, "You have called for me, and I have come."
Solitude and goodness penetrated from her.
She began to speak to him and to give him prophecies about the future, warning about a great war that may occur between Russia and China and surrounding countries. She was showing him a map of the Soviet Union and fires breaking out there.
In the meantime, the prison is in an uproar. Guards rush in, trying to make sense of this tremendous light. And as they opened the door of his cell, the light disappeared.
They were stunned to see this man alive. He should have been frozen to death. They were equally stunned to feel the warmth, the heat in that cell. And they accused him of using yoga and all this other stuff. And he said, "No, I was visited by an apparition of the Virgin Mary."
Joseph was placed in a psychiatric hospital for observation, but he was far from crazy. He claims he'd forged a permanent connection with the supernatural, a connection that made him a conduit for prophecy and brought him renown throughout the world. Joseph still had years to spend behind bars, but he used his time painting and to secretly orchestrate a Ukrainian human rights movement.
Reagan за мене інтерв'ював.
I was quite well known throughout the world. President Reagan, President Mitterrand spoke in my defense.
After surviving 23 years of misery for refusing to renounce his faith, Joseph Terelya was released from prison. But his journey wasn't over.
He was expelled from the Soviet Union because he was engaged in anti-communist activity with the Catholic underground, with the Christian underground in general. He also worked with oppressed, persecuted Jews. And so they wanted him out of the country, and they exiled him to Canada.
It wasn't until he reached the West that the world learned of the magnitude of prophetic visions Joseph claims were given to him by the Virgin Mary. Joseph Terelya's spiritual director, Bishop Roman Danilak of Toronto, Canada.
He spoke before the joint houses of the Senate and of Congress, with people at the Pentagon and the White House itself.
He has seen the Pope more than 36 times. 200 prophecies of Joseph have been released by the Vatican, and his visions are essentially apocalyptic in nature.
There will be a great flame or fire in southern Russia. A person will appear called Vladimir. He will call on Russia to destroy Israel.
He has spoken of the San Andrea Fault and the Pacific Coast going to the brink.
The southern parts of the states and the coast of California, there will be earthquakes, and it will sink into the water, or be covered by water.
Joseph warns us that even though we may think things are peaceful, even though things may seem to be going very well in places like the Soviet Union or China, to watch out, because they could be powder kegs that are ready to explode.
In my mind, there is no question that the apparitions taking place in many places of the world are valid. They are things that science cannot explain, and certainly cannot be explained away by labels of mass hysteria.
Just as the icy cold was about to take his life, Joseph Terelya claims an ethereal glowing woman saved him with warmth. He survived 23 years in a Soviet prison camp with 9 years in solitary confinement and continuous unimaginable torture. However, if his prophetic visions of our future are true and they go unheeded, the worst may be yet to come.